All right, guys, so what we're doing now is showing you the LG C10 to the right, the Samsung Q8FN to the left, and this is going to be a demonstration on FreeSync, not necessarily, just kind of like gaming mode in general, if you will. So to show you what I've got right now, I'm in gaming mode right now, as you guys will see soon as I open up the picture settings. I'm in game mode user, additional settings, and then AMD FreeSync Premium. We just toggle that on because what the hell, why not, right? Okay, and then grab my remote here, open up the Q8FN settings, and as you guys can see, we are in game mode, but you'll see that once I go to External Device Manager, game mode settings, game mode is set to on, and then premium for the, not premium, Game Motion Plus settings maxed out. Samsung being the only manufacturer that allows you to have motion smoothing in game mode while maintaining input lag. Game-changing stuff. Been saying it since I got this TV. FreeSync Ultimate. So they have two tiers. You have the basic and you have the ultimate. And then you have off. So unlike LG, you don't just toggle one thing. You have a choice between basic and ultimate, which I think is cool. Gives you a little bit more user control. Now, one of the things that is abundantly clear is that a lot of people try to tell you that OLED is always going to have better contrast. But in brighter scenes like this, if you look at the mountain, the LG C10 is not keeping up with the Q8FN as far as mountain details. The contrast is rendering darker, things like that. Like the horizon is more visible on the Q8FN. It's just an entirely different beast, right down to the rocks on the ground being more visible on the Q8FN. I wish I had a way to kind of zoom in on that kind of stuff and show you all those finer details, but I don't. I can tell you that it is very dramatic, and it's not even a remotely close thing, especially as I'm driving up. The contrast, the separation, the isolation of both game modes. Obviously, the Q8FN taking the cake here visually. I mean, look at as we wrap around, and you can see the shadows rolling off the mountainside because of the luminosity and all that stuff. Or at least I hope you can see that kind of stuff. I don't know if you actually can. It is absolutely incredible to see what the Q8FN is pulling off for being a so-called, you know, LED, mid-range LED TV that some people try to label it. It's a fantastic high-end display, and it beats pretty much every single QLED that they have on the market right now. And that's not a bold claim. That's just because Samsung stopped trying. Really, honestly, I think it's incredible to see this TV hold up. I'm going to try to enter a race so you guys can see, or let's go to the hub first so you guys can get an idea of what the hub world looks like. And this scene is always pretty dark on both displays. Both are doing a decent job with shadow detail in that regard. As the scene loaded up, I did have a little bit more detail on the QLED, or rather the OLED. But that's now gone away, and now it's just kind of like they're very equal, at least as far as detail. Because when you get to color, brightness, and all that other stuff, the Samsung Q8FN is going to look better. Now, this is important to note because when you get to next-gen gaming, Xbox Series X, PlayStation 5, you know, this is going to be your experience. You're going to be missing out on all this color, all this brightness. Motion smoothing's not going to be available on LG C10, and I just think it's a shame to pay more money and get less gaming features. This line of television from Samsung, the Q8FN, was really made to challenge OLED, and you're seeing it do so very excellently, as I have all the contrast in the world I could possibly hope for. A lot of people were asking to see how this would fare in game mode, and I just wanted to show that off. Like, in game mode, it does a brilliant job of holding its own. I mean, I can't even look at the C10. That's how often my eyes go over to the Q8FN. Now I'm trying to look at the C10 and see if I notice any real differences. The first thing I notice is that I immediately want more color because it just feels muted. It doesn't feel as wonderful. And this is just like me just kind of, you know, giving you the play-by-play as I kind of experience it. It's lacking. I'm kind of cheating a little bit, because as I look at the Q8FN, it's like my eyes keep looking over at the prettier Q8FN, because it's just grabbing my eye subconsciously, so I'm trying to stop it from doing that and just kind of keep my eyes on the prize, you know, just look straight at the LG C10. And when I do that, I'm noticing motion is really choppy, is the word I would use to describe it. Like, especially crashing into that tree, I did not like that. I'll crash into another one and another one. I don't like the choppy nature of everything. It's not smooth at all. And I feel like a lot of people are expecting with this brand new FreeSync technology it to smooth everything out regardless on even if a game supports it or not. That is not what FreeSync is for. FreeSync is only going to stop frame tearing for games that are 120 FPS because of the variable refresh rate that it's going to have, the varying uncapped frame rate basically, and your mileage will vary. But you know, there's also some VRR issues that you guys know about with the raised gamma point, as HDTV Test so generously called it. I call it gray black. You can call it whatever you want. Black is gray when you use VRR. I have noticed it. Don't really have the patience to set up my PC again and do all the testing and all that. You know, because of all the complaining lately, I just really think no matter what I show, it'll always resort to that. So I'm not going to do all that justifying and exposing and all that. I think you guys get the idea. This is more so to give you an idea of how it will fare with actual games that you'll play that you own right now. Now, as I look at the C10 and the Q8FN, I would say the C10 is doing way better as I drive through the cotton field. I can see every little cotton plant, you know, where on the Q8FN, it wasn't as clear when in motion. As I look between the two, in motion, I can see a lot more, like every little circle. This is like really nitpicky, but the detail is definitely there on the C10 for sure. And that's that OLED benefit. But then again, when I look over at the horizon, the contrast and everything is just more striking on the Q8FN. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna try to go into a race like I was saying earlier. I have a race I guess I already have started up, so why not? Let's just go and see what happens. I can safely say that this isn't gonna be an easy choice for somebody who I guess is expecting a day and night difference between, you know, OLED and QLED in the terms of motion performance and things like that. But I mean, it's gonna be a big difference when you look at some scenes. Like, as that scene was just on that last loading screen, the C10 looked better. On this loading screen, the Q8FN looks better. So they trade back and forth depending on what you're looking at, and that's the part that sucks about these comparisons, because then you start to feel like, well, maybe they're so similar, why not just go for the more detailed one or the more expensive one and just kind of call it a day? I mean, it's up to you guys, obviously, but my recommendation is to wait till 2021 when they actually have their act together. All these manufacturers didn't try in 2020. That's why a lot of my older TVs are beating this newer stuff, and I think that's sad. Now, the detail on the vehicle looks a lot better on the LG C10, and that is grabbing my eye a lot more. As we go over into this thing where I'm missing my checkpoint miserably because I'm paying attention to the C10 and not even, I'm like looking and studying the details, not even like just racing, but as I look, I can see a lot more detail on the C10, gravel on the road, A++. The sign is definitely as sharp as the Q8FN. Q8FN's keeping up very well with that. But it's the little things like the grass, the gravel, that's the stuff that makes, you know, you really look like you have a super powerful gaming rig. And right now I'm just playing on the Xbox One S. I'm not even using the Xbox One X, but the extra detail that the C10 has makes me feel like it is the Xbox One X in some areas. And that I cannot say about the Q8FN because it doesn't have the OLED benefit of pixel level illumination. Though, that being said, it does sometimes come as a double-edged sword in darker scenes, so that's something you're gonna have to weigh up yourself. Now I'm doing this race on the C10. Water looks crystal clear. It's all beautiful. Check. I don't have any problems with it. I mean, color is a bit muted, but, you know, it's passable. It's an enjoyable enough experience. Now looking at the Q8FN, I'm immediately in love again. I see the nice, beautiful soap opera effect that I love in gaming, and it's just a joy. The beautiful colors, the motion is to fucking die for, like you wouldn't believe. Detail is lacking a bit by comparison to the C10 when I go through the grass, and that's something that can definitely be felt. Those tangible differences of the finer details are why people choose OLED. Personally, I love gaming on my Sony A8G Bravia OLED. I don't really pick LG because I don't like the muted color, and Sony is just doing it a little different for me. And nobody put me up to the task of saying that. I don't care about any brand. I'm just putting it out there for anybody curious. I know a lot of people ask about the Vizio OLED, the LG C10, and the Sony A8H. Which one would I put my hat on? I mean, honestly speaking, I really loved what Vizio did this year. Their OLED was really beautiful, but their picture settings locked, and really, it was just a glitchy mess. So I would have to give the edge to either the A8H or the C10. And seeing how the C10 is a little washed for color to be nice, I would say I would go with the A8H. Now I'm driving like complete and total dog shit right now because I keep getting distracted. I'm trying to pick out differences between the two displays. But what I can tell you is, I think at this point, all the C10 has going for it when you go up against Samsung QLED is the fact that it has pixel level illumination. So you have that finer detail. But outside of that, literally everything else is a win, because as I'm gaming on the LG C10, and I know a lot of people are expecting the input lag to be the game changer, but I don't notice a tangible difference. Look, so right now, well, you can't really see me, but as I'm looking at the screen, I'm looking at the LG C10, and now I'm going to look back over at the Q8FN, and I'm going to tell you right now, I have no problem switching from one or the other, because the difference in millisecond is so minuscule at this point that it honestly makes no difference at all in performance. And I've experienced this online. I've never had any problem with Samsung's 21 milliseconds, like literally ever. It's always been bang on for me. I've never ever had a situation where I've lost a match because of 21 milliseconds. I've always been able to just dominate. So that's just what I say there. I don't think you really, from a TV perspective, need more than 21 milliseconds. I think anything else will be really hard to not only have the dexterity to respond on a 14 millisecond level, 13 millisecond level, and even lower. I mean, really, unless you have like really laggy internet, which that's what milliseconds are for, I suppose, to help that latency. But honestly, guys, I don't notice a difference. But then again, I'm not online, so I can't really say that. But what I am saying is it's a nice experience on both displays. I know casually, right now, offline, just doing my thing, I'm not having any problems, so I just kind of wanted to put that stuff out there. Now, as I look at both displays again, the LG C10 has more detail, which is super impressive as you get to scenes like that. But the brightness of the Q8FN, the color, all that stuff is great. And then again, in some scenes, the clarity is beating the OLED. So that's like crazy. Like right now, the OLED's getting spanked right now in the just clarity of the image, really. But then again, we already knew that that was something that the LG kind of struggled with a bit. So, food for thought. I don't want to drag this on too long. I just wanted to kind of cover it because I know you guys were wondering, like, for gaming, how is it? I know some of you guys maybe wanted to see shooters. Maybe I'll do like one more video with that. But honestly, this is the comparison between these two TVs. Again, LG C10 is to the right, the Samsung Q8FN is to the left. And if I had to pick one, I would go with the Samsung Q8FN, because even though it doesn't have the finer detail, that is only one aspect of it. They do have the motion smoothing. They do have the auto low latency mode. They do have the responsiveness behind the input lag. And honestly, when I look at the two images, I really get my breath taken away by the Q8FN more times than I can care to count. The C10, though, is not doing terrible on this scene. It's just too dim, and it lacks that punch. If LG could ever get their screens a little brighter with a little bit more three-dimensionality and contrast, with some extra, again, just sting to the image, that punch and pop, the clarity, kind of like what Sony's doing, I think I would be sold on LG every day of the week. And I think maybe that's just my personal preference speaking, but I think a lot of people kind of share my sentiment that the Q8FN and the image quality that you're seeing right now is just absolutely gorgeous. So I really hope by giving this out it helps you. And again, good luck when you're shopping around. I know there's a lot of misinformation floating around, a lot of people trying to make a lot of money through influencer marketing. I'm not trying to do any of that trash. If you want an honest person to help you out, subscribe, you know what to do. Hit the bell notification when I do awesome content like this. And again, thanks for watching the number one brand in honesty. Until the next video, I'll see you guys later.